So hey guys, we are in the kitchen and
yes,
I'm Louise.
And I'm Ania.
And okay, so here is the question, Ania. And I don't know if you can hear, but my oven's running in the background. You may hear it, you may not be hearing it. Where is the best place to keep your wine?
Best place? I thought you were going to.
Where is your worst place to keep your wine?
Because that's an easy one. We're sitting in it.
Boom. Want to know why?
Well, because the temperature in your kitchen fluctuates all the time.
Especially when you're running an oven.
And what does wine not like?
Heat.
And sunlight.
And sunlight. So when you keep your wine, the worst place is going to be the kitchen. I don't even care if it's in a pantry. Just get it out of the kitchen.
Yeah.
One of the best places to keep your wine is...
Oh, I wish I had a cellar. Wine cellar. Or just basement.
Yeah. So cellar, basement cellar, or a actual wine cellar is going to be the best place.
Yes.
Because the temperature underground is going to be cooler
and
darker.
It
because
doesn't matter.
No sunlight.
Yeah, it doesn't matter if it's summer or if it's winter. It's going to be constant temperature is what you want. Now, clearly, many of us don't have the luxury of having that space. So what are some other good places that you can think of?
Stick it in a closet in the basement.
But we don't have a basement.
No, don't have a basement. Stick it in the closet in your coat closet. No, just anywhere you can keep it in, like a dining room, a living room, anywhere where it's away from direct sunlight.
Yes.
And far away from the kitchen so that you don't have that heat in it.
Because, well, keep in mind where your heating element is.
Yes.
You don't want that on and off temperature. You just
right.
want it constant.
Away from any Ooh. Type of heat exchange too, like any type of, you know, if you have baseboard heating or even the air ducts. Keep
so
it away from
I do have a question which
yes.
was not planned, but this brought, like just came. So what do you do if you have wine delivered and for instance, it's cold outside and
temperatures, if you're getting wine delivered to your home and you have extreme temperatures, let the wine sit for a week.
Yep.
1 week. Just let it sit. Let it get back to normal.
Because don't touch it.
Don't drink it. Don't do anything to it. Just take it inside and leave it alone. Because while it goes through those extremes, it could go through bottle shock and all the ingredients almost separate themselves. All right. So
and you can sometimes tell because the cork will start coming up.
Yeah.
Especially with the wine. Wine could potentially become almost like a slushy. We've had some wine.
We've
delivered.
Had wine slushies before too.
That too. But when it comes
but
semi-frozen,
yeah.
Or in the summer, you have the heat. So just be patient with it.
Yes. Patience is a virtue.
Absolutely.
And don't keep it in the kitchen.
No. And you know what? Unless it's a really, like you open it, the bottle and it's not what you expected, it's not your taste, flavor preference, or maybe it went bad, then keep it by your stove because you want to use it for all of your cooking. Throw it into your stews,
perfect.
Your sauces, then it's okay. But
there's always reason to use wine somehow, some way. Even if it's bad wine, just use it for cooking.
Absolutely. So protect your wine, save your wine, keep it safe.
Keep it safe. All right, guys. I'm Louise.
I'm Ania.
And don't forget to subscribe below. Thank you for tuning in today.